tight squeeze under a bridge. We can all breathe again. They've made it.
With Cerberus, the Greek mythical hound.
Thank you.
This forest is a death trap. You motherfuckers aren't gonna get away with this. Shit, I didn't think I was gonna make it. Thanks for that. I'm Sarah, by the way, Sarah Perkins. Was heading up a wildlife conservation team studying the wolves in the park, and then, well, we found these things. They're wolves, but not like anything I've seen before. The cult calls them judges. Bigger, stronger, tougher than the other species around here. The cult tried to force my team to help him. When we said no, they sicked those things on us. Eli and the Whitetails got me out. Been trying to pay them back ever since. I've got a theory on how to use the cult's formula to help us track these creatures. But all I'm working with is corpses. I need a live judge. I know it's a big ask, but I'm desperate. The cult's training him at an old youth camp called the Breakthrough. Do this for me, and I might be able to put something together that'll help you hunt these things. I'll meet you at the camp once it's clear.
Glad you showed up when you did. My whole team was taken and strung up for these monsters to train on. Was just luck that I wasn't taken too. Fuck, I mean, I've been studying these judges for months now. It's, well, to put it bluntly, pretty weird shit. Essentially, Jacob and his soldiers have been pumping these poor wolves full of some kind of drug. No idea what it is, but it's turning them into war machines. What's worse is the cult seems to be able to control these animals. It sounds crazy, I know, but I've seen the judges follow human commands. The scariest part of all this is that I don't think they're limiting these experiments to just wolves.
Them alive. Let's use that pen over there. That should work. Okay. Oh, they weren't just my colleagues who were killed.
Now the fun part. Lure one inside. Whitetails are the only decent people I've met here. What's the problem? Just get in and get out. Sure, you were gonna pull it off, but you did it. Oh, will you look at him? Beautiful. Eli's a good man. Where was I? Right. Can't thank you enough. With this guy here, I've got everything I need to synthesize a formula. Here, take a test batch I was working on. Should help you hunt these damn things down.
They want you to be strong. One of you will be strong. Not again.
Get out of here, peaches.
I know you are in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were going to work out. She always had faith. And one day she was going to go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was going to live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me. When nobody from nowhere with nothing. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. Plan for me. So I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped on her angelic face and I pinched it shut. And after a little while, her legs began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth, and the Lord take. Pain, sacrifice, these are all part of His test. And we have to prove that we can serve God, no matter what He asks.
That's it.
Victor!
Good. Call the herd.